CSW6. End-to-end football, I felt like we were lucky not to lose that game, but equally, I feel like we performed... I mean, people aren't happy with the performance, but to get back into it, I thought we did a good job.
Yeah, it was a quality game of football. There's no two ways about it. And I suppose the downside is when you're 2-0 up, you know, you expect to go on and just win the game and cruise it. However, having said that, when we went 1-0 up, great goal, by the way, David Luiz, 1-2, 1-2. Great goal. I took it really well. But the signs were there around about 30, 35 minutes. They had three really good chances. And they're a good side, really good side. That number four for them, and we obviously were really interested in the Belgians at Nangmeijer, the world.
Yeah,
fantastic.
He looked good, yeah.
Everything was going through him. And then, of course, you know, they got their goal, which I don't, was it Aspilicueta at fault now? I couldn't really see properly. But,
our defence was looking a bit shaky. I remember the third time I met Jake saying, like, the defence was looking a little bit shaky, and within about 5 minutes of that, they scored their goal.
Well, they took 2-1, and then, of course, they're back in the game, aren't they? And then at the second half, you know, we got Dzeko, you know, what a finish, you know. And you have to say, they were really in command of the game at that time, you know. So to come back, I suppose, to show a good bit of character, 3-3, you take it. I suppose the disappointing thing is the fact that at 2-0 you wanted to cruise it out.
Yeah.
And of course it would have allowed us then to go to Rome and rest a load of players, because we got Man United 3 days afterwards after the game out in Rome.
Yeah.
But I suppose cloud on the, you know, on the horizon, if
silver
you like.
Lining,
yeah, silver lining and all that one. The result with the other game, fantastic.
I mean, so yeah, it's gone our way. Points, yeah. They're not performing as well, which is quite strange. But I think our main issue here is that why did he take David Luiz off? Was it me, or did he have like a knock or something that we didn't see? Because he didn't seem to protest very much when he did come off, but I thought it was a strange substitution, if he wasn't injured,
well,
that is.
Absolutely, but I mean, I take it was at Palace at the weekend.
I saw the game, I was in bed ill, but
I don't wish
to look at the... But I said in my preview, like, David Luiz has to be in midfield. He's not a defender. I don't care where he is. I don't think he's a very good defender, at least not for Chelsea.
I quite like him in holding midfield. I thought that's the one thing that Rafa Benitez has got right. You know, and I really do like him in that position, because we all know he's got the mistake in him, you know, or two, and he's a great passer of the ball, and he can move the ball really quick. So I like him in that position, and I can see the logic behind it, because it's on Saturday, they were playing everything through the centre. When you've got Bakayoko and Fabregas, one's got to sit, one's got to go. And they were both going, and of course they were knocking it through the middle, Sahar, and that's where we were, of course. So maybe that was in the back of Antonio Conte's mind, that's the way he did what he did. But look, the way you got to look at it, I suppose, is look, we went 1-0 up.
And they came and they played really well. To be fair,
I think
David Luiz hadn't scored, to me, what wasn't like, it wasn't a set of goals, just him going on his own, then they may have even got the first goal. I think that shocked them a little bit.
Absolutely.
And it sort of gave us the head start.
They had plenty of opportunities, didn't they, really? As I say, even
Courtois
when
we made some brilliant saves.
Courtois did make some good saves, but they also had some missed chances as well, where they got themselves into great positions. And, you know, they could have very easily won this by 2-3 clear goals.
Yeah.
I don't think we were particularly great today, but we got a draw, and we're still top of the group.
And some of the things have been corrected from the Palace game. I could see little tweaks that were looking better, and Christensen, I have to say today, he made some fantastic tackles, especially in the box. I think how hard that is not to give away a foul.
Fantastic, Christensen.
He should be in the team.
You know, maybe we don't want to have that conversation, but maybe the Gary Cahill one at some point, we've got to have it, because, you know, with all intents and purposes, we have got a very well accomplished back three now.
Yeah.
Rudiger's a quality act as well, you know, he's a good player, really good player.
Conte likes Cahill, doesn't he? He doesn't want to drop him.
He likes Cahill, but the thing is, you have to compensate, because he's not the quickest, and you know. But look, Aho, I thought he played KL.
Yeah.
We got a point. It's a good point.
It's a good point. And Atletico Madrid drop points, so we can't be upset with that.
Absolutely.
Okay, quickly just before you go, a score prediction for the away leg.
Well, I'm going out to it. You going out to it?
I am.
Yeah, fantastic. Thomas Cook?
Oh, no, I know. I have to book my flight yet. I'll get there.
Okay, cool. I reckon we'll get a draw out there. And a draw will be good enough, yeah.
Yeah, well, a draw, yeah. I'm thinking we're going to win for either of
us. I think we're going to win our game, you know, in back. I think we're winning back.
Yeah,
I think we'll win that game.
Okay.
And we'll go for it. We'll be all right.
Perfect. Thank you.